to the airport for the second time. I got about 2 miles down the road and realized that I needed to go back. Alright. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna like this new thing if you can hear me. This is the loudest fan I have ever owned. I'm gonna plug in here. Extremely windy today. I don't know if it was dust or what. Oh, here we go. So I am bouncing down my dirt road. Oops, sorry. This is terrible. I probably should just start this again, right? It's so bad. Yay, there we are. Oh, look at my new shirt. Before I get out here on the highway, it says, don't practice until you get it right. And then it says, practice until you can't get it wrong. We couldn't see that, but that's what it says. So, this is funny. Someone had borrowed a bag to take their puppy home in, which we don't mind a bit. And he sent it back to me, and I didn't open it when he sent it back to me. I just stored it. So today I'm headed to the airport and I needed it, and so I don't like that light on my face at all. So I opened it and bam, out popped two shirts, one for me and one for Lily, and some stuff to rub on my sore muscles. Some real Chinese medicine. So, whew, this van is so loud and the wind is blowing so hard today. So my little sidekick isn't in here with me to write down my own odometer reading. Well, this is another gift that Giuseppe sent me. It's very sweet, very nice pin. Lily's going to be looking for us some new pins this weekend while I'm gone. She's going to be I thought I had put the hearts on the fawn girl. I'm sorry. 4:30 this morning, and this is really typically who I am. If I can get 6 good hours of sleep, I'm great. So I did. I've been getting bed earlier, so I've decided I have to start at 8:30 if I want to get in bed by 10. So I did. I started at 8:30 and I was in bed by 10. Asleep by 10:30. I'm sorry, baby, you're having a hard time. I was wide awake at 4:30, so I just got up and I've had a fabulous day. Alec got sick at 9:30 and had to go home. I don't know what was up with that. I haven't heard from him. I don't know what I would do without Lily. Oh, she's just so amazing and helpful. So amazing. Although I didn't let her pick her shirt. I said, I want the long sleep one. You can have the short sleep one. I mean, she likes her shirt. So you can't see the back of it. It's got Giuseppe's. He runs a martial arts school. And it's got his. I'll do it where I can turn around and show you what's on the back. So I don't know what city they're in Southern California. I'll remember if I ever visit them. They have a Holly Berry puppy named Georgia. Yeah. Those Holly Berry puppies were beautiful. I'll probably be sorry I didn't keep one, but I don't have any more room. I've got Legacy and Infinity and Serendipity in the only place I had for them. And even then, I haven't really gotten them out and leash trained them yet. We did walk Steffi and Callie today. So I'll be very interested to find out how the numbers fall on the Bull Mastiff specialty. So typically they ask me every year to support an entry, and I always send them $80 or whatever. Usually do $2. And nobody even contacted me this year, so I don't know. But it's okay. We'll go down there and scoop up the prize. This on his page. which to me is a bit inconsequential. And when I did his hip x-rays in September, he was born in March, his hips looked fabulous. And I actually found that picture. And my vet clinic that took that picture, their vet clinic caught on fire and they lost. They didn't lose the whole clinic, but they lost their x-ray machine and they lost. It was awful. The whole inside of the clinic was black. They had to redo all of the cabinets. It was pretty bad. But praise God, it didn't burn all the way down. Should be, right? He had him 65 pounds. him where he was dragging his back leg. I can preach, and I can teach, but if people won't listen, and they want a big dog, and they do this to their poor puppy, I just cringe, because I see the damage that it does. Another thing, if you are overfeeding your dog, or even giving him too much protein, you can cause pano, which is a painful thing where the bones grow too fast. You really need to back off the protein. So, I had one boy that had pano, and it was Daisy's brother, and we were butchering. A lot of people had cows die that spring, calving, and so I was just throwing him, and he wasn't really overweight. He really didn't get that overweight, but he was just growing too fast, and it took me probably 2 months to get that back in control and get him. So, the truth is, dogs are created to eat the dead and dying, and a coyote doesn't go to the refrigerator and pull out a tube of hamburger. They eat mice, the whole thing, right? The hair, the fur, the feathers, the feet, the everything. So we just sometimes overdo it with our dogs on one hand, and then on the other hand, this crappy dog food that these huge dog food companies are packaging and marketing to us like they're good, and they're not. They're horrible. Horrible. I read a study the other day that most golden retrievers used to live to be 16, 17, 18 years old. Now they die around 12 to 14 years. And it's the dog food. We're killing our dogs with dog food. Not because it's too nutritious, but because it's just horrible. It's not necessarily what it's lacking, but it is the horrible stuff that's in it and the preservatives, right? So, yeah, I know that is a big soapbox of mine to say. If what was on the package was actually in the dog food, it would probably be good. But it's not. And if you went to a dog food company and you watched them make dog food, would not feed it to your dogs. I can't imagine why you would feed it to your dogs. It's horrible. In fact, I read a study that said that they were taking dog food and finding out what was in it, and the they put dogs down. You can even put a horse down, right? With this medication. It's a controlled substance. And at these big shelters, they put a lot of dogs down every day. I mean, it's horrible. It's horrible, but it's true. So they were finding this substance in the dog food. So what that means is, Terry Seville. She's so funny. She's got her
little bitty girl voice. But still, she has some wonderful things to say. And she said something the other day that's like, right? She said, if you're not working on it, it's really not a dream. And I haven't picked up my books I've been writing in a long time. Actually, I did write this morning, but I haven't really written probably in 4 or 5 months. I haven't written, just like, I can write all the ink out of a pen, okay? When I get to writing, I just write and write and write and write and write. So I need to get back to my writing, because I love to write. I can probably write for 8 hours. I know, that sounds crazy, but I could. So full of content, huh? So full of something. So I'm gonna sign off. Oh, there's a hole in the road. They filled the hole and it's just a big bump. My shoulders are better, but they're certainly not well. I saw the chiropractor yesterday. He did help me, but I am certainly not there yet. I'm still going numb today between my shoulder blades. So, I don't know what else to say, but the Lord said this morning in prayer, He said, bear the fruits of love, which are goodness, kindness, patience, peace, gentleness, joy, right? Let us bear the fruits of love, right? Walking in the fruit of the Spirit, not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So, you know, I think it's interesting when I think about Romans 8, where it says, where Paul says, if you are carnal and you're carnally minded and you're walking in the flesh, it says the flesh cannot please God. That's what it says. It says the flesh cannot please God. Only walking in the Spirit, which is faith, can please God. That's really good. Really good time in prayer this morning. I took communion and it was really good. It was really good. All right, I'm going to be in 5:30 traffic. So check that out. Romans 8. Paul had a lot to say. Romans 8 is one of my most favorite chapters in the entire Bible. It's just a very powerful chapter. It's just talking about I don't know if this is an 8, not being overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. We're talking about what shall separate us from the love of God? Nothing. Not height, nor depth, nor principalities, nor powers, nor the present, nor the past, nor things to come. Nothing shall separate us from the love of God. And it says, when it says height, nor depth, I always felt like that meant riches or poverty, right? You can be as high as you want. The social status or as low on the totem pole as you can get, but it doesn't mean that that would ever separate us from the love of God, which is in Jesus Christ our Lord, right? So it's a good word, Romans 8. That's how it ends up. All right, I'm signing off 25 minutes later. I don't even know if